In first of all, you see what is your pivot element in table 1. First of all, you see what is your pivot element. If you remember, I have marked pivot element will be what? Roshni.
Sir, 3.
3. Okay. So all of you see the first table. So I have mark 1 square, mark by square. Element 3 is our pivot element. Okay. So, and delta j value is what? All the delta j values are positive or negative? Delta j value in the first table?
Positive.
Positive. So you will remember at least one value is positive, then we find out the minimum ratio. Then we cannot get an optimal solution. Optimal solution means solution. We cannot get a solution. So here you see 3, 5, 4 delta j value. Delta j first value is 3, second value is 5, third value is 4, then 0, 0, 0. 0, 0, no problem, but here positive value. So at least not use to get an optimal solution. So up to this clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next, we find out how to find out the minimum ratio. Minimum ratio find out will be, formula will be XB, capital XB. Capital XB divided by incoming vector. Capital XB divided by incoming vector. So how to find out our incoming vector? Those delta J, here you see which delta J is greater. 3, 5, 4. Here which one is greater? 5 is greater. So yes, 5 is greater. So 5 belongs to which column? Y2 column. So XB by Y2 is our, Y2 will be our incoming vector. Y2 will be incoming vector. Next, minimum ratio will be XB by incoming vector, means Y2. So first element of XB is what? 8 divided by corresponding element of Y2 is 3. So 8 by 3. Second, 10. XB element of second one is 10. Corresponding element is 2. So 10 by 2. Okay. Next one is 15. Corresponding element is 2. So this is 15 by 2. So you see, minimum ratio is 8 by 3, 10 by 2, 15 by 2. So here, which one is the minimum value? Which gives minimum value?
8 by 3.
So here, 8 by 3 row means S1 row. S1 row will be our outgoing. S1 row will be outgoing. So corresponding to one column outgoing. You see, row S1 will be out. Similarly, in column way, S1 will be out. I have written outgoing. So here, pivot element will be intersecting element of incoming vector. So incoming vector is Y2. Outgoing vector is S1. So here, where intersect? In the element 3. So 3 is our pivot element. So you see, this is clear or not? Show me. Any doubt in the first table?
No, sir.
Arbaj? Okay. So you see in the second table you see second table cj xb these are same means cj coefficient of the objective function will be 3 5 4 0 0 0 all of you see the second table then xb I have written y1 y2 y3 then I have written y4 y5 y6 all of you write this is s1 s2 s3 because in the first table I have written s1 s2 s3 so second table maintain s1 s2 s3 not y4 y5 y6 s1 s2 s3 this is clear
yes sir
okay so when you write then you will cut this one and write s1 s2 s3 so next one what we do our out means minimum ratio row first row is our minimum ratio row so minimum ratio row first one is s1 so s1 variable will be out s1 variable will be out and this is replaced by the incoming vector so you see our s1 variable will be out you see I have marked out symbol arrow symbol this arrow symbol means out so s1 variable will be out and this is replaced by y2 মানে এস ওয়ান ভেরিয়েবল যোনটো আছে এইটো আউট হৈ যাব হৈ কিনি এই এস ওয়ান ভেরিয়েবলটো রিপ্লেস হৈ যাব ইনকামিং ভেক্টৰৰ ভেরিয়েবল দি পেলাই মিনস ওয়াই টু ইজ আৱাৰ ইনকামিং ভেক্টৰ ভেরিয়েবল সো ইউ সি ইন দা সেকেন্ড টেবুল ইন ক্যাপিটেল বি আই হ্যাভ রিটেন এস ইন প্লেস অফ এস ওয়ান আই হ্যাভ রিটেন ওয়াই টু সো ইউ সি দিস ইজ ক্লিয়ার অর নট clear
yes sir
okay next what is the coefficient of y2 what is the coefficient of y2 y2 coefficient ki asile in objective function what is the coefficient of y2
sir 3
yes not y not 3 y2 in objective function y2 y2
so 5
yes good 5 you see in object here I have written y1 y2 y3 s1 s2 s3 and cj means coefficient of the objective function means y1 coefficient is 3 y2 coefficient is 5 in the objective function y3 coefficient is 4 similarly s1 coefficient is 0 s2 coefficient is 0 then s3 coefficient is 0 roshni clear this is objective function coefficient okay.
yes sir so the wrong one
this one you have so next what in cb means coefficient of the basic variable means here you see in y2 to cb here coefficient I have written 5 okay next what we do first row is divided by the pivot element so you see first row means in the table first row means 8 2 3 0 1 0 0 have you seen first row
yes sir
in the first table yes,
yes sir.
So this is divided by the pivot element so pivot element is to divide all the element by you divide all the element by 3 means first one will be what 8 by 3 second one will be 2 by 3 next 3 by 3 is 1 so you see 1 next 0 by 3 is 0 then 1 by 3 then 0 by 3 is 0 then 0 by 3 is 0 so you see in the second table first row is complete clear
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next, you move to the second row. So second row, this basic variable remains same. So S2 will be S2, you write, and its coefficient is 0. So I have written 0. Next, what we do? Next, we calculate in the second row, new table, second row means in place of 10, what will be the value? This is clear? In the second table, in the second row, in place of 10, what will be the value? So how to calculate? This will be, formula will be one thing. The second table gives us the new element. Okay, all the elements of second table is called new element, and old table gives us the old element. Okay, first table is now old table. So all the element is we shall call old element, and second table is new table. So all the elements we shall call this is new element. So next, we calculate in place of 10, what will be the value in the second table? Okay, so in the first table, what is the value of second row? In XB column, second row, first table will be what?
10.
First row, 10.
10.
So 10, yes, yes. So 10, 10 formula will be 10 minus corresponding element of key column. What is our key column? Key column means key element is called key column or pivot column. So what is our key column? Which column is key column? কোনটো কলাম কি কলাম হব আচ্ছা পাইভট এলিমেন্ট ইজ হোয়াট হিয়ার ইন দা ফার্স্ট টেবল
থ্রি
থ্রি সো থ্রি মিন্স ওয়াই টু কলাম উইল বি আওয়ার কি কলাম ওয়াই টু কলাম ইজ আওয়ার কি কলাম সো টেন 10 minus corresponding element of key column. 10 minus key column.
2.
2, good. 10 minus 2, yes. 10 minus 2 into corresponding element of pivot row. Means, you see, 10 present, so it's corresponding element will be what? Here you see 8 will be corresponding element of key row. You see 3 immediate calculate value is 10. So 10, so here 8 will be the value. So 10 minus 2 into 8 divided by pivot element means divided by 3 means 10 minus 2 into 8 divided by 3. You can write in rough ways, you can write. If you calculate one table, then you can easily calculate other table. Okay, so eto bujhe paisa ne 10 minus 2 means actually formula will be new. You all of you can write the formula new element equal to, you can write formula in note, you can write new element equal to old element minus intersection of key row and key column, intersection of key row and key column divided by pivot element. Pivot element will be only divided by means cos intersection of key row and key column divided by pivot element. Divided by pivot element. This is clear. You've written.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next one, you see, next we calculate which value.
Sir, for like
yes.
For this element, like will it be 10 minus 2 multiplied by 8 divided by 3? Like I have some like doubts.
3.
So like, but like in the second. Yeah. Like table, like I mean you have written 14 by 3, so like how did it
get so you see not divided by whole divided by not pivot element old okay. element okay then minus
oh so sorry
old element oh, okay. yes
okay sir.
Old element minus then you can write in bracket intersection of key row key column divided by pivot element not by whole means old element is you see 10
by 3 minus 2
10
divided
10 minus 2 10 minus 2 into 8 divided by 3 10 is separate not 10 by 3 10 is separate old element is separate old element then minus then you can write bracket intersection of key row key column divided by two bracket old element is separate not whole divided by pivot not in whole divided by pivot element only old element is separate old element minus first bracket intersection of key row key column divided by three then bracket now okay
yes sir
so 10 minus what 10 minus Roshni 10 minus 2
yes sir
into 8 divided by 3 so 10 minus 16 by 3 10 minus 16 by 3 so equal to what we write equal to 10 minus 16 by 3 means LCM is 3 so 30 minus 16 divided by 3 so ultimately you see first one will be 14 by 3 it's okay clear
yes sir
okay so next you calculate the second element so what is the old element for second element what is the old element you go to the old table means first table
zero
15. zero minus two corresponding element is two okay and then you see 0 minus 2 into what? Into what? Zero minus 2 into anybody? Acha, here which row is fixed? Key row is fixed means our pivot element is 3. So first row is fixed so all the second row element and third row element is calculate with the help of the first row element so you see 0 minus 2 then corresponding value of 0 is in the pivot column is 2 and corresponding element of pivot row will be what 0 pivot row
2
corresponding element 2 so 0 minus 2 into 2 divided by 3 you see this is clear or not
yes sir
So ultimately, minus 4 by 3 means though first row here, all the element of second and third row is calculated by first element, means first row element and calculate with the second row and third row. And next you see, next value will be what? Acha. You see in column wise, you see in column, which column is outgoing? Which column is outgoing?
S1.
S1 is
outgoing.
S1 is outgoing. S1 is outgoing. So S1 is outgoing. So you see, incoming is which column?
Y2 column.
Yes, Y2 column. So just you copy and paste. Mean S1 column element you copy and paste to incoming vector column. Just you copy and paste all the element. You can copy and paste. So Y2 column will be in the second table like what? Y2 column will be
100.
100. You see, in S1 column, in S1 column 100, this vector will be out, and this is out and paste in the Y2 vector, means Y2 column. So 100 will be like in Y2 column. You see, so one already got na. One already got, so here 0, and third row again we get 0. Okay, so this is without calculating we write. Okay, next you see in Y3 row element 5 will be replaced by what? In Y3 column and S2 row, Y3 column and S2 row, element 5 will be replaced by what? What will be the formula in the second table?
Five minus 2 into 0 by 3.
Yes, good. Everyone clear?
Yes, sir.
Then Ishita.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so 5 minus 2 into 0 divided by 3. So what is the value after calculation? After calculation, what is the value?
5.
Okay, so next you, what is the value of 0? Means S1 column and S2 row. How to calculate 0 element? 0 minus what?
0 minus
old element. Yes.
By 3.
0 minus 2 into 1 divided by 3. So ultimately what we get? Minus 2 by 3. So you see, this is clear or not? Ripon. Ripon, bujhe paisa ne? Shudev. Shudev, call. Clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next we calculate S2 column and S2 row. Means element 1 is calculate. How to calculate? So 1 minus वन माइनस
सर 1 माइनस 2 इंटू 0 बाई 3
सो अल्टीमेटली माइनस अल्टीमेटली जीरो वन माइनस अल्टीमेटली दिस वैल्यू विल बी वन
सर 1
वन वन नेक्स्ट इशिता नेक्स्ट वैल्यू हाउ टू कैलकुलेट If you have any doubt, you can ask. Because if you calculate in one table, if you calculate, then automatically you calculate the other tables. Is it the next key of calculation? Arbaj?
Zero minus two.
Zero minus two into.
So 0 divided by 3
0 minus 2 into in the first row you see corresponding 0 which element we consider corresponding element of key row so in key row you see our key row means first row is our key row so 0 calculate so in this table corresponding element is 0 so 0 minus 2 into 0 divided by 3. So ultimately, this is 0. Clear or not, Ishita?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, third row, how to calculate? How to, fifth element 15 will be replaced by what? Anybody? Roshni, Arba, Chishita. 15, how to calculate? Element 15 will be calculated by what?
Fifteen minus two, two, eight, three.
Yes, good. 15 minus 2 means 15. Its corresponding element of key column. Our key column means what? Three is our key element. So its column is called key column. So 15 corresponding element is 2 into corresponding element of key row. So in 15, corresponding element of key row is what? Our 8. 15 minus 2 into 8. Always we compare with the first row. Here because first row is our key row. If second row is our key row, then you compare with the second row. So first row, so 15 minus 2 divided by 3. Clear or not? 15 minus into 8 divided by 3. Okay. So next one will be 3. How to calculate the element 3?
Three.
How to calculate?
Two in three. 2 by 3.
Yes, Arbaj. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And next element is automatically 1. We already got. Next element 4 will be replaced by what? Element 4. 4 minus. What? Ishita, 4 minus 4 bars. Next element, 4 minus what?
Sir, 4 minus 2 multiplied by 0 divided by 3.
3, yes, good. So ultimately we get 4, na? Okay. Next element, 0, how to replace? In second element, how to calculate?
0 minus 2 into 1 by 3.
Yes, so ultimately we get minus 2 by 3. Okay. Next value. Next value. Next 0 minus 2 into 0 divided by 3. Yes, 0. And last one, 1.
Minus 2
1 minus.
multiplied by 0 divided by 3.
Yes, so ultimately 1. So you see, in the second table, now you see, in the second table element is we calculate first row, second row, third row, we calculate. Next, our calculation is what? Z equal to CB into XB. So CB into XB, you know how to calculate? Means 5 into minus 8 by 3 plus 0 into 14 by 3 plus 0 into 29 by 3. So we get the Z value. Clear this one?
Yes, sir.
Same as earlier. Next you calculate delta J. So first value is delta 1. Same way as earlier, delta 1. So delta 1 you calculate C1 minus CB into Y1. So after calculation, minus 4 by 3. You can calculate na this one, same as in the first table. You can calculate, all of you.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So delta 1, delta 2, delta 3, delta 4, delta 5, delta 6. So up to delta 6, we calculate. Okay. Then this gives us an optimal solution. This gives us an optimal solution. Optimal means solution. This gives us a solution.
No, sir.
Why?
At least one element is less than 0.
No, not less than 0, greater than 0. Because here 4 is greater than 0. Means if all the elements is less than or equal to 0, then optimal solution. If at least one element is greater than 0, then we cannot get an optimal solution. So you see, minus 4 by 3, this is less than 0. 0, this is equal to 0, no problem. Then minus 5 by 3, this is less than 0, no problem. 0 and 0. But here, problem is what? In delta J, 4 is positive. At least one value is positive, then optimal solution. If more than one value is positive, then we find out which gives us an maximum delta J. So here, which one is incoming vector? Here, which one is incoming vector? Here you see 4 is positive, so y3 column is our incoming vector. This is clear. So next we find out the minimum ratio. So minimum ratio will be xb by incoming vector, means y3. Clear? So xb, what is the value of xb? First row of xb value is what
Sir,
in the first row?
I had so, like some doubts regarding the incoming and outgoing. Like, how do we like decide on which one is incoming, which one is outgoing?
Incoming vector will be maximum if maximum delta J value gives us the incoming vector. Maximum delta J. মানে delta J value to silo in the second table. Delta J value into maximum.
So the 4, which is maximum.
4.
Yes, sir.
So this column is called the incoming vector. Because here you see, here all are what? Negative and 0, 0, then no problem. We will not search. Only searching the positive value, delta j positive value. In positive value, if more than one positive value, then we check which gives us the maximum delta j. Okay, so here only one positive value, means 4 is maximum. Okay, so y3 is our incoming vector. Everyone clear? Arbaj, which
yes, sir. And outgoing one? Outgoing vector?
Outgoing will be depend upon the minimum ratio rho. So next we find out xb by y3. Means xb divided by 3 means incoming vector. So ratio will be x first element of xb element is what? Xb first element ki ase?
8 by 3
divided by corresponding element of y3. So what is y3?
0 0.
So 8 by 3 divided by 0 is what?
Infinite.
So in minimum ratio, you will remember infinite value and negative value occurs, then we will not write. In minimum ratio value is suppose negative one or infinite value, then we will not write. So I have written, you see, dash symbol means this is we will not consider. Next, in the second row, what is xb element? What is xb element?
14 by 3
divided by 5. So ultimately what we get? Ratio will be 14 by 15. Next, third one will be 29 by 3 divided by 4. So 29 by 12. Okay, so here you see which gives us minimum ratio, 14 by 15 or 29 by 12.
14 by 15.
So this 14 by 15 row means 14 by 15 present in which row? Second row, means S2. So S2 vector will be out. So in column, you see which one is S2. So you see, I have written Y5, you cut this one Y5, this is actually S2. So this S2 will be out. So S2 will be our outgoing vector. Arbaz, clear? How to find out outgoing?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here you see pivot element, how to calculate? Which one is the pivot element? Intersection of minimum ratio row. Minimum ratio row is what? S2 row will be minimum ratio row. And Y3 column is the incoming vector. I have given symbol incoming vector. So here, where intersect? In the element what? In the element? In which?
Five.
Yes. In the element 5, the intersect. So 5 is the intersecting element of minimum ratio row and incoming vector. So 5 is our key row or pivot, key element or pivot element. Clear this one?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So up to this, you see, up to second table, up to calculate this one. Okay. Response your number name. To calculate. Okay. Then second table element will be your old element, and third table element will be your new element. Okay. All of you will try. Arbaj, then Roshni, all of you will try. Ishita.
Yes, sir.
Okay.